everyone. So I have made a promise that I will share a few ideas and a few things that have helped me to start my own business and actually to make it a successful business. So thank you for taking the time to watch this, and I hope it will really help you with your desire of getting into business or growing your current business. So why thus? I've always wanted to share of what has worked for me, because I think as when I started my own business, I thought that things were a certain way, but when I got into it, I saw that things are not as they seem. So most people will say, I wished I knew what I was getting myself into, or I wished I understood more than what I actually understood before I go into business. And that is also important, because there is a lot that goes into running a business or starting one, but how you handle that is what will determine if you make it or you don't make it. So I then thought, a lot of people come to me and ask me the question, how is it that we can start our own business? What are the most important things? What is it that we could do? That one thing that we can do and be able to break through. And as a coach, so I'm an international accredited coach in life coaching, money, financial wellness and money. And I sit a lot with clients who are needing money for business or for their own personal lifestyle. And starting a business is one of the things that a lot of people want to do to get into that financial freedom place, which is not a bad idea, but it's also a big step that needs to be thought out carefully. Well, every time that I went into business back then, I just quitted my job without any giving it much thought, and I just went into this thing twice actually. So yeah, I think that has to do with my way of thinking, obviously, because I always thought if I wanted to do something, I just need to do it. But I wouldn't say it's the best way of doing it, because obviously there's a lot of things that are involved, and if you like to go into business and stay in business, you want to do it right. The statistics are out there that says in 5 years, all the business that I started in a period of 5 years, only 20% make it. So it means that a lot of businesses do not make it to 5 years or 3 years. I mean, there's all those stats, you could look them up, but doesn't mean that they can, you could be part of that, either one, you know. You could be at the 20% or 80% category, but that is not something that should make you not do what you want to do. So that's how I always looked at it. But again, as I said, there are a few things that I saw in my journey that I would love other people to know and be able to use to get to their goal quicker and easier. Actually, just get there happy than saying, oh, it's been so hard. So the first thing is that you need to prepare. If you want to leave your job, you need to prepare for that. It should be, you should put proper planning around that. So now, the one thing is that preparing is involves a lot of your mindset. So for instance, if your current situation right now is the best situation that you've ever been, that's a great place. You will start planning from this place. But if your current situation is a place that you definitely do not like being at or being in, and you're just not happy with the current situation, what I will advise you is that do not plan on this what is currently happening now, you had already created a long time ago, a year ago, 6 months ago. That is what you're experiencing right now. And if it's something you don't like, then I will say your plan should not be attached to the now, to what's currently going on, because then you might just duplicate what is currently going on, and you don't want to do that if it's not a place that you love to be at. Now, what I would suggest is that you do not plan anything in for the current, for the next 3 months. What you start doing is actually planning for your next year. So now it's 2017. Do not plan for that. Let 2017 plan out the way you had sort of visioned it in the past, but plan for 2018. So right now I would like you to look into these 5 things that I'm going to share with you, looking into 2018. Because what will happen is that you will change this consciousness that you currently have and are at now, and you will project into 2018 a place where everything is currently okay, and a place where you're not stressed out, a place where you're not trying to get air because you are suffocating, but a place that's just good. So we would like to plan for that space. So the first thing is that your current income source, if you are already in business, you have a specific current income source, and if you are in a job, you also have an income source. But now, what is another type of income source that you have currently? So look into all of those. So if you have maybe you have stocks that you invested in, that would be another type of income, or you have another business where you sell something, or you have anything else that you're doing other than your main source of income. So look at that, sort of write that down, because that is a very big part of what you could do forward, looking at having a sustainable business. Now, this extra income source should be definitely something you love, something you enjoy doing, because if you're going to go into business with that, your business chances of failing are, they're going to be very less. So look into your life. Do you have another option of an income source, or do you have another income source, or do you can you think of another income source for 2018, not 2017? Okay, so now if you already have one extra from your current one, can you have another one? So can you have three? Can you have four? Why I'm saying that is, when you are running a business is not as stable as we would like it to be. So there is so many things that can happen in a business or cannot happen in a business that might put you in a tight corner. And once you're in a tight corner, the thing is, you get stuck, and once you're stuck, you can't actually push this business, because this business is going to be on your shoulders. No one is going to be telling you what to do, and you don't want to be in a stuck point. So now, I'm a coach, I help a lot of people get unstuck, and I've seen, I would say 100%, everyone that's in a stuck point is in a stuck point because of money, mostly. It's there is times where it could be health or a love relationship. Those two other things can get a person in a stuck environment, but money is the one thing. So I do not want you to get stuck, because then if you come to me for coaching, I'll have more work to do to get you unstuck. You can get unstuck, but it's a little bit more work than just starting from a place of creating and growing. And a lot of people that are also in jobs are getting stuck in debt, and that is another place where as a coach, I have to dig you out of that, which I definitely don't like doing, but obviously because it needs to be done, it needs to be done. So you don't want to get stuck. So you absolutely need to have more than one income stream. That's one thing I did. I currently have 7 streams of income because of that same thing. You want to have peace of mind. You cannot create anything. You cannot create millions. You cannot create a big empire when you do not have peace of mind, because your mind is the tool. And if it's not in peace, if it's in debt, if it's stuck somewhere because you don't have enough money, you can't have the things you want in life, you can't. So you need more than one income stream, not one, not two, not a lot. So I'm saying I'm currently at 7 and I'm still making more income streams, because it is very important to have peace of mind. That is the reason why you have income streams, not just for fun, it's for peace of mind. So I'm taking this video during sunset, so I hope we'll have enough light. And well, this video shouldn't be that long because YouTube does not want long videos also, so I'll probably make it in part 1, 2, 3 so that it's not that long. So the other thing is that look into 2018. How would you like to maintain your lifestyle in 2018? What is it that, how much do you need? What do you need in 2017 to maintain your lifestyle? So when I say maintain, I'm not saying go and say I want a new car, I want a house. I'm saying for you to have a comfort in what you currently are living. I'm not saying upgrade. I'm just saying in 2018, what will be comfortable for you as a lifestyle? So then we can know that if in 2017 per month I am going to need 10,000 rand to function, maybe not, maybe less or more, but that 10,000 will be enough. So have that amount, know how much you will need, because if you're going to go out of business, you then going to want to live a healthy lifestyle, a normal lifestyle, not a lifestyle of struggling month to month, not being sure where what's going to come from. So know that amount, have that amount in mind. Okay, so so what currently are your basic needs? So when you are going to go into business, you're going to need capital at some point. I'm not saying you cannot go into business when you, if you don't have capital, but I'm saying that you will need some sort of financing, as in maybe your normal day-to-day while you're starting your business, or maybe the actual business that you're going to start. So you need to know what is your basic needs. So what is that I cannot live without? So how can I then say that needs to be taken care of? Definitely, for sure, I need to travel. I need to travel to meetings. I need to drive. I need to eat. I need to have a room under my head. So it is those important things that you need. And then now look at the other income streams. What those income streams, each of them at the most basic, can give you. So if you are currently now earning 40,000 rand a month, now you want those income streams to be able to cover you. So those income streams should be giving you at least about 50 grand a month. So, and that's a very easy thing. I remember when I started my business, I was earning a certain amount, and the first month of starting my business, then I tripled that amount. And I was, what? My goodness, I could have done this all my life, you know, because I did not understand that I could use the same amount of time and productivity and actually make 3 times the amount I'm getting every month. So that was a good thing. But then you need to know what is that basic amount, because that's what you're going to live on. Hence, you need to have dealt with your debt, you know, if that's possible, you need to have dealt with a whole lot of other things that are not necessary in your life so that you can now be able to focus on your goal. So hence I'm saying 2017, don't plan for that, plan for 2018. In 2018, I would have gone through and fixed my debt. I would have gone through and fixed this. And now in 2018, I actually can be able to finance myself to start this business in with a clear state of mind, with peace in mind. So if that is in place, then you almost good to go, because that's the most important thing. Another thing that I would have really, really appreciated if someone had told me is to get a coach. Now, a coach is someone who helps you through your hurdles and through your mountain climbing in your business and through your most darkest moment in business. But the good thing about a coach is this: if you had a problem and solving it by yourself will take you a period of 6 months, when you have a coach, this is what I do myself. I take one day, I cry about my problem, I cry and cry. At the end of the day, then I just like, okay, this is it, I've cried enough about this. The next day I call my coach, because they are not attached to my problem, they do not see what I see, because I'm attached to it, I'm in the same level with it, they are in another space, they are not having this problem. So for them, they have peace of mind around this problem, so they can see all the solutions. Will give me a solution in a week, I will be done with this. But if I didn't have one, I would take 6 months to get over that. And one thing we don't have is time. Time we do not have. So you don't have 10 years of dealing with one problem. You definitely want it sorted out as soon as you can. So get a coach, get a mentor, get someone that is in business, that understand what business is, because you also don't want to find someone who's going to say to you, don't do this, don't do that. You want someone who's gonna push you to the limits and giving you guidance and giving you their network and giving you their expertise and their experiences, so that you can learn from that. So a coach is a very, very, very good investment to have. I went and started coaching because once I had a coach, my life changed. My life actually progressed. And I thought, you know, if there's one thing I'd like to give back, because that's what I went and started coaching for, to give back to people who needs this help, who are like me, who say, I want to go out there, I want to do this, but I need guidance, I need some sort of guidance. And I started coaching to do that, to be able to not just share my experiences, but able to guide people through a process of getting them to a certain point. So I am going to cut this video, because now time is it's a little bit long, it won't be able to upload well. And I will continue on part two probably next week, and I'm going to give you, so if you don't have anything in mind specifically right now, I'll give you a few things and a few ideas of what businesses you could do and how can you actually find the one that you can be in love with. So how do you find what you love, and what is it that you could do with that? So that will be for next week. But for this week, remember, plan your year from a peaceful place. So plan the next year, 2018. Look at what you can do for extra income, and look at what will be your basic needs that you need to take care of while you grow your business, and look at how long could it take before your business actually makes your basic needs in amount or number. But also, one thing I've seen a lot when I coach my clients through especially this process of starting a new business, leaving your job, is that a lot of my clients think that they don't have enough time to already starting a business while you are at a job. Now that is just a wrong belief, a limiting belief, and it shouldn't be actually said out, because you have more than enough time to have four jobs in your 24 hours. Now, I know you could have kids, I have four, you could have a husband, I have one, you could have everything else, like extra everything else that you do, but you have enough time to at least have two more jobs above the one you have. And you can find the time if you want to find it, if you're really serious about this. So starting your business right now is not even an, it's not an excuse. It's not, you can start your business right now, run it, because you have enough time to do it. I run businesses, not one, and I still have time to do this. Not that because I've got extra hours or anything. I have so many things that are going on in my life every moment. But because I know what I want to do, I do those things. So I'll really advise you to start already and find the time. Do not make time an excuse for you not doing what you need to do or what you want to do. Time is not a problem at all. So thank you for coming through. You could definitely connect with me on my website. We have a lot of great programs. Now the one that we currently are doing is a debt program, a 6 weeks program where we're looking at how you could get out of debt and get out of debt for good, get out of debt in not just getting the amounts that you owe paid up, but clearing the energy, because debt is just a symptom. There's a whole lot of energy that you carry with debt. One of the things is that if you feel that you're not good enough in what you do, you're not good enough in this life, you're not good enough in what you're giving to the world, in at your job, the value that you give, you do not appreciate that value enough, you're probably gonna be in debt, because that is one of the causes of debt. And we're dealing with that in a 6 week program. So if you want to join in, you can still join in. We're currently in week two. In week one, we're looking at creating more money and versus paying your debt. And we saw that you can't create with that energy. Hence I said, that energy, when it's still with you, you cannot create more. You need to sort that debt, that energy out. Not especially the amount, but the energy of debt in your life needs to leave before you can be able to access your creative energy where you can make millions. So that's one of the programs. And another one is how to get unstuck. So that also looks into how, if you are putting up goals but the goals just don't seem to happen, and over you're trying the same goal and you're trying to get it done, you're pushing, but it just doesn't get there. Getting unstuck talks about that. There's three things that can get you stuck. One is not knowing what you want. The second thing is being scared of saying this is what I want, because I want, maybe you want to start a business and you're saying, I can't start a business because I've got kids, I need to take care of these people, I owe so much, I there's so many things, I cannot actually accept that this is what I want. So let me just continue doing this. And the third part is when you actually have found what you want, have decided to say this is what I want, and now you are in it, but you're working up yourself to almost dying and nothing is getting done. So then you do feel stuck, you do feel like, what is it that I'm not doing right? I've done everything, I've taken all the advice, but it's still not working. So those are some of the programs that are there. And we also have the money group, the Facebook group. If you want to join that, just send me an inbox, I'll add you on the group, and you will on a daily basis get exercises that will increase your vibration. Now once when your vibration is high, you are able to access the things you want to access in life. So if you want to access a job and your vibration is here, you're not gonna get the right job offers, you're not gonna get the right people that are looking for you. You know, if you're people like in network marketing, you literally getting people that are saying no every day because you're not in the right vibration, you're not attracting like-minded people. So the group helps you on a daily basis. You literally on a daily basis are implementing something that increases your vibration. So check that out. Send me an inbox if you want to join. So thank you for watching this clip, and I will do another clip next week where we'll talk about ways of how to find out what you need to do, what you want to do, what you can do as a business if you don't have anything in mind yet. And thank you for watching again. See you next time. Bye.